Today, sustainability is a central point of discussion for the Land Securities Board. Today, all our new buildings have to meet demanding efficiency and emissions targets that represent massive progress over a decade. Today, not only have we a full house of attendees from across our stakeholder base, we also have the participation of some of the leading figures in property, business, and thought leadership. My point is the environmental debate and the notion of sustainability in the round have entered the business mainstream, and that is my basis for optimism. Just look at the difference it's made to Land Securities, both in terms of our buildings, technical capabilities, and the way we do things as a team.
Back in 1990, emissions were rising at about 1.5 parts per million per annum. They're now rising at nearly 3. Not even the worst recession since the 1930s makes more than a blip on that curve. So for all the goodwill and all the effort, the achievement has been approximately zilch. And it's extremely important, if we're to address what is one of the greatest challenges of our age, to recognise that the existing package of policies has not delivered the goods, and business as usual probably won't either. The really positive part of the story is that the energy sector is probably engaged in a technical revolution pretty much equivalent in scale to what we've seen in communications.
This idea that, you know, we're using up more than a planet's worth of natural resources, and that just doesn't make sense. So we've got to think about how we do things differently and smarter and live within the means of the planet. Lots of stuff that everybody does day in, day out, and then when you add it up over time, it is absolutely transformational.
Customers said, actually, we care a lot about green. What we don't care a lot about is paying more for it. Mm. But if you can show us a way of doing it, i.e. prove Al Gore's thesis that sustainable businesses can be more profitable businesses, then, you know, we'll have a crack at it. So we got that into the business. There was a bit of resistance. We rolled it out to the customers. And 3 years later, M&S produced on audited numbers £50 million more profit attributable to Plan A.
We're seeing a coalescence of our shareholders, of our staff, of other interested parties, of suppliers, around this set of core values. And I think that's where business can make a real difference. It's not only its own operations, but the sphere of influence it has.
I basically made it very clear that unless people were willing to understand sustainability, that is to say, do 70-odd hours of online training about the subject, they weren't going to be working for me. We win mandates to manage money for third parties that we absolutely win principally because of our sustainability characteristics.
Conviction is something that we also need to add to the mix of decision making. We can now say that we're producing tens of millions of square meters of carpet based on 100% renewable energy. We have closed the water loop in our plant here in Europe. Nothing goes through landfill. And our benchmark here, which is 1996, the company has been able to reduce its carbon footprint by 90%.
I'm having people knocking on our door saying, can we come and work for you? And that makes a real difference to how successful we can be going forward.
This is really good for business. Being a sustainable business and being a successful business are one and the same.
The leadership role in this whole process is absolutely core. And for the leader to believe and truly believe that behaviour change alongside technology and legislation and the other things is an integral part of the change process is absolutely real and authentic. And if you don't have that, then I think you're going to struggle at any business in whatever you do.
In terms of working together, there's lots of opportunity, particularly on infrastructure, on public space, on being able to give scale, to take new ideas, new technologies forward. and working much more collaboratively with the supply chain to make things happen. And I think the future that holds for us is going to have a lot of change, as we've heard in some of the earlier talks. And taking those things forward can be a challenge, but if you do them together, that makes it easier.
The big problem is energy is going to go up very, very high. And for a property audience, here's the question I'd ask. At what point, and it's happening in certain places outside of London, at what point does the energy bill per square metre go higher than the rental bill? And if that happens, will you be discussing rental prices or energy prices with your customers?
Thinking in terms of London as a city, it presents huge opportunities in terms of new technologies, examples of extracting waste heat from the tube network, for example, or from the transmission network.
No city around the world is immune from the pressures of urbanisation, climate change, demographic change. These are mega trends that aren't going to go away. You look at the impact this has on the cities, on the erosion of green space, on the impacts of traffic congestion, poor air quality. I mean, all over the world we see it.
London Wildlife Trust research showed that between 1998 and 2008, London was losing 2.5 Hyde Parks to gardens being paved or decked. So we were losing huge amounts of effectively healthy ecosystem for all the purposes we needed for. And I think the more that developers start looking at all the opportunities to actually retrofit a bit of nature, the more we're going to start seeing some serious positive impacts on nature.
Sometimes if you just sit back and realise that the technology that exists today has the ability to deliver absolute transformation in these cities.
What's coming out of the pipeline that gives us reasons to be hopeful about a better world? The great thing is that pipeline is absolutely bulging with new ideas, thoughts, technologies, software, systems, processes, information management. Absolutely bulging on every score. Combine renewables with storage, with energy efficiency, with smart grids and building management, and that's your revolution.
Much of today has been about thought provocation. And I hope you leave here reflecting on how you can make an impact by reducing your impact.
Our eyes were opened up today by all the speakers.
I was really excited by the amount of attention that was given to behaviour and the importance of leadership and the right decisions and behaviours within the built environment. One thing that I think really struck home was the importance of harnessing the creativity within both communities and also your employee group.
Lots of thought-provoking stuff that we can put into our work plans and ideas for the future. I think it was very positive that it ended with a can-do attitude and the we can deliver some of the challenges that are ahead of us.
It's brilliant, really, really exciting calibre of speakers.
Well, the best bit of today to me was the fact that Landsec showed the commitment to the sustainability agenda throughout the way they run their business.